Yeah, I know the first game, the fact that you got parking tickets indicated that she does have a driver's license or something like that. But like, or that in Arcadia Bay, like the police department just doesn't care that a non-certified driver, vehicular operator is just, you know, driving around in an old-ass truck. But oh well.
Hello?
You know no one's homegirl? 0722, going to the office. Okay, it makes sense because, you know, he is a DA. In case someone breaks in, you know. I'll have information on
I
them.
need to search this office for any communication with Sarah that can help me find her. If it can rain ash, I guess it could snow in LA. It's the big one.
Why does she always like shake the snow globe? Is she about to smash something?
Best dad. That stuff is all politics anyway. Sweet. A secret key. Now to find the secret lock.
I really do love like her development here.
I guess getting your ass kissed comes with the DA territory. I guess getting your ass kissed comes with the DA territory. Pro tip: when digging for secrets, try the DA's computer. Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act.
James, this is enough. When you told me at the part that you weren't gonna let me be a part of Rachel's life, of course I was angry about it, and just that you need to protect her. It's your prerogative as a parent. But sending that man to talk sense to me, sense into me, threaten me, you're losing the moral high ground here. What kind of a way is that for a DA to act? What would a voter say? I have the right to meet my daughter, and the lawyer spoke with me agrees. I spoke with agrees. But most importantly, Rachel has the right to know who her mother is, to know the truth. Do what you know is right. Sarah.
More sherry. James sure keeps lots of files on people. James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom. What do we have here? I should check the computer or some of those files laying around. Arcadia Bay's least wanted.
Age 31, 6'3", 180 pounds, hair brown, eye brown. Everything there within there is been, I'm sorry. Why? I can write assault with this weapon. 20, 15. Oh Jesus, it is windy today. Oh yeah, I'm definitely not leaving for MacFest anytime soon. Thomas Lumber, precinct 215. Precinct 205. Allegations. A verbal altercation with the victim, Merrick brandished a fire poker, hitting the victim several times about the head before fleeing to the American Glove, who recovered and entered into evidence. A 911 call received at 10:21 p.m. and an officer arrived at the scene at 10:38 p.m. with EMT. The victim was taken to hospital. Bystander requested to remain anonymous, named Damon Merrick at the assailant.
Locked drawer inside locked office. Seems promising. Sheldon. Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
Wasn't Sheldon like, the bouncer at the mill?
Welcome to Shadyville.
There'd be like a gun in there or something.
James's stamp collection.
It's holding a gun. I don't know. The camera of some sort. No, phone.
Sarah sent all these letters. And James never gave them to Rachel? That's so messed up.
I'll be right back. And I'm back. Let's see. To my Rachel, my name is Sarah and I'm your biological mother. The first thing you should know about me is that giving you up was the worst mistake I ever made. I was struggling with something at the time, something that I've been battling ever since. That battle has taken everything from me, most importantly you. But now I'm in a place where I know I can be a part of your life. It's more than I deserve, I know. But I would love to try if you want to. Please take your time. And if you have anything to say or any questions, hearing from you would mean the world. I love you very much, and I hope to meet you soon. Love, Sarah. There's Rachel. I hope it's alright for me to write you again. I haven't heard from you yet, and that's okay. It really is. I feel like I have so much to catch up on, you know? I don't remember much of my life as a symptom of the choices I made. So much I've lost except you. I remember everything about you. The crinkle of your nose, the depths of your eyes, the knowing smile that somehow made it seem like you've seen it all before. I can call it up whenever you want. I want it as clear as a summer day. I was so afraid that I would be a terrible mother to you. That would screw you up the way I screwed up so much of my life. Now I know, of course, that my fear was wrong. Far worse than being a bad mother is never knowing what kind of mother I would have been. I'm sorry. If you can find the courage to forgive me, maybe we can start over. I want to, with all my might. I want to. Love, Sarah. Beautiful Rachel, I read somewhere, maybe a fortune cookie, that you can never step in the same river twice, because after it moves, it's not really the same river anymore. It's something new. Do you think that's true? I try to picture you reading these letters. I wonder what your reactions are, how it might seem to you. This mysterious mother, I don't blame you for not writing back. You will write when you're ready. I imagine your dad is still wary of this. That's okay. James is protective of you, just that I would be. But he is also a kind and compassionate man. That was the problem, really. I wasn't cut out for him. All the life he wanted to give you, I knew it then, even when he didn't. I know we can never have the same relationship we should have had, but I hope we can have something new together. I hope it very much. Hope it so much. All my love, Sarah.
The Sarah in this letter doesn't seem anything at all like the person James told us about last night.
James, I understand reluctance. Let me speak with Rachel, but don't you think this relationship belonged to her? Everything I've done over the past year has been to prove to you that I am better to be in Rachel's life. I have been gone through rehab, I am in recovery, and I am no longer in need of money or assistance. I know I can be a positive influence for her. I'm coming to Arcadia Bay in the hopes that we can at least meet to discuss this, so you can see how much I've changed. But if you have any feelings left for me at all, you will give me a fair chance to prove myself to you, and hopefully to Rachel too. You were the love of my life once. Please don't take this away from me. Sarah. Dear Mr. Amber, I represent Sarah Gerhardt, lawful mother of Rachel Amber and petitioner of partial custody of Rachel Amber, her lawful daughter. Please take notice that Oregon law requires current guardians of minor to respond in good faith to any and all lawful petitions by parent to reestablish contact with their children. On behalf of my client, I hereby demand that you cease and desist from unlawfully denying contact between Sarah Goodhart and Rachel Amber. You are now considered to be on notice. The continued review will result in a petition for suit filed. Suit filed under Oregon Family Law, Statute 42-4B, Tillamook County Family Services. The letter constitutes your final notice on this matter. Sincerely, Kevin G. Shapiro, LCC.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
So, this looks like Sarah stopped cashing the checks James sent her. Guess he forgot to mention that during his story last night.
Wow. I hope the money, for what it's worth, going by the letters, I hope that that's the way the money to at least get better, which I assume, because she did go into rehab, and then that money was for a lawyer. Presumably, that money went to a lawyer. So I hope that money went to a good place, especially if she took the money instead of just seeing her.
I have to know who James is talking to on the secret phone of his. It could be about Sarah.
Until you can help me with my problem, cross the line, let's talk. We'll call tonight. I found who you were looking for. Call you in 15. Well, this isn't a charity. I'm going to need you to do what we talked about. I can't. Sure you can, because I talked to your girl, and she has a big mouth. Turns out she's not so easy. We're going to need more hands on. Don't hurt her. Relax, I got my best guy on it. How's your daughter? You know, she tired of me for a fight. You should really teach her to behave better. Nothing? I guess you don't need this taken care of anymore. That has to be that statement.
James is working with Damon Merrick? This is insane. What were they talking about? Is the girl Damon's talking about Sarah? Whatever is going on, I need to see if Damon knows where Sarah is. But how do I get him to tell me?
Can't threaten him.
What do I say? Hope James actually has this evidence. Don't think Damon will tell me where Sarah is. Unless I send him a picture. Shit. Which of these is Damon talking about? I could just take a wild guess and see what he says. Or maybe there's some info on the case hanging around the office. Could this be the evidence? Damon and knives seem like a solid bet.
No, that's not the victim.
Did Damon really shoot someone? Guess I shouldn't be surprised.
Oh, you fucker.
Huh. If TV has taught me anything, these babies will be swimming in DNA.
Let me check the files.
James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom. Sheldon. Why do I feel like I've heard that name before? James sure keeps lots of files on people. Arcadia Bay's least wanted.
Okay, the gloves, the gloves, okay. Okay, I know it's not the knife because they use a fire poker. The knife was just today.
If I can figure out how. How do I destroy a glove? Maybe I can burn it somehow.
I'm pretty sure you had enough of a fire. Shit. I mean, mean, not that it matters now. You put your fingers on it, and the DNA. They're gonna drop it? Like, yo.
Oof. Better not touch that again.
Don't they have fire detectors, smoke detectors? Since you're destroying evidence, might as well tell me which one of my guys was a snitch. Okay, we're on to something here. Well, I don't know. Can't say no one's get colluded with someone. Can't say no more because I'm not really obliging. So. Sorry, that's your job.
Damn. I hope James has something here to tell me who Damon's informant is. So I need to find which of Damon's guys has been snitching. I should search around the office to see if there's any info to help me out.
Planning supper, what time do you think you'll be home? Don't wait for me. Sweetheart, you don't get enough family time as it is. Does Rachel want to join us? She's very welcome to. Mom, I can't make it tonight. Sorry. COVID, everything okay? Yeah, everything fine. Okay, love you. Love you too. But I say, tell your mother you love her. Damn. Won't let her hug you or anything? Shit. Oh, I'm not gonna. Let's investigate.
Okay. There's no way that Frank is snitching on Damon. But I love learning about his badass loitering charm.
He's a Virgo, okay. Details detained between May 23rd and 25th, 2006 by Arcadia Bay Police Department on suspicion of drug dealing loitering. Drug dealing charges dropped due to insufficient evidence. Okay, nothing here.
This is that freak from the mill. Wonder what Damon would think of his very cooperative comment.
Oh, it's that dude who like rocked with a bottle and then his friend punched me. Was not arrested in the last month. Employed. Chef leader. Company. Have been very cooperative. No miss check-ins. Parole. Oh, he's on parole. Okay.
I agree to aid the courts on future cases. That could be seen as a little snitchy.
Gerald Scott. Okay. Charge illegal sale of stolen goods. Huh. agree to aid the court in such a case related to my own. Right, I'll just have to judge it.
Sarah sent all these letters, and James never gave them to Rachel? That's so messed up. Guess I'm lucky James keeps so much info at home. Okay. If I'm going to accuse one of these guys, better be sure I'm right.
Frank had shot.
I totally knew this guy was a criminal when I stole from him. Could this douchebag be the snitch Damon's talking about? I guess this explains why Mr. Amber knows so much about Frank.
I don't think that's not Frank, obviously. He's been trying to keep his head low.
This guy let me into the mill. Cool dude. I totally knew this guy was a criminal when I stole from him.
That? Okay, so that. I just need to know the two names that showed and I was like, this is.
Feels a little weird having this guy's records at my fingertips. This is that freak from the mill. Wonder what Damon would think of his very cooperative comment. I'm lucky James keeps so much info at home. I agree to aid the courts on future cases. That could be seen as a little snitchy.
That's hard though, because it's like, I don't know, Sheldon, because he's very cooperative. I mean, both were really willing to cooperate. I don't know what this dude was doing other than selling t-shirts. I think that dude was inside. I don't know what I didn't see much of him, so there's not really much on him to accuse him on, other than that he was a bouncer. And he just seems sketchy from the start.
Could this douchebag be the snitch Damon's talking about?
He looks like a snitch. And as it's on the file, he was very cooperative. I'm gonna go with that.
Payment? Fuck.
That doesn't tell me anything.
Here's hoping James already has Damon's money. But where would it be? Sarah sent this. So this looks like Sarah stopped cashing the checks James sent her. Guess he forgot to mention that during his story last night. Looks like a recent email from Rachel's mother to James. Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act. I wonder if this has anything to do with Damon's stash.
Wow.
Holy shit.
A shitload of money. And it's a flip-flop. Flip phone. Here's your girl ready to go.
Fuck, that's Sarah. And she's at the mill. What is he doing to her?
Ruin the package so we can finish the job.
Shit. Does James even know what he's doing? Okay, I still have time. Damon's waiting for his money, right? He wouldn't do anything to her. Yet. Fuck. I need to get there.